Let's discuss about the half-life period. So this is also very important concept in chemical kinetics. So let's define here what do you mean by half-life period or half-life period of a reaction. So it is the time during which the concentration of the reactant that can going to be reduced to half of its initial value. So that is denoted by the T off. So here in this half-life period, so very important two expression here. So one is called the expression for the half-life of a zero order reaction, or this is also can be called that the relationship between the half-life period of a reaction and rate constant of the zero order reaction. Second one, expression for the half-life of a first order reaction, or relationship between the half-life period of a reaction and rate constant of a first order reaction. So we know this one, we already derived this one, right? Zero order reaction we have discussed already. So let's start with the simple expression. So we know this one, the rate constant for the zero order reaction we know very well, that is K is equal to, this is called rate constant is equal to, for the zero order reaction, just to recall here, so that is called the initial concentration of the reactants minus concentration of the reactant divided by the time t, right? So divided by time t. So this is called initial concentration of the reactant, and this is the concentration of the reactant where this is t. So this is what equation number one. This tells us the. So this is what zero order reaction. So now according to half-life period, so what is the t? I am going to substitute as a t is equal to t of, and it's very important here. So this concentration of the reactant, I am going to take it as a initial concentration of the reactant divided by 2. So now I am going to correlate with this our definition. What else? It is the time during which the concentration of the reactant, here the concentration of the reactant is this one. This is called initial concentration of the reactant. So the concentration of the reactant which is going to be reduced, how much? Half of its initial value. What is initial value? That is R naught. So that's why I am going to take the concentration of the reactant as the initial concentration of the reactant divided by 2. So now the according to definition we are going to follow here. So now I am going to substitute these values in equation number 1. So what it becomes? K is equal to, this will be as it is, will be there. So this is initial concentration of reactant minus this, substituting the value of R here, that is initial concentration of the reactant divided by 2, that whole divided by T will be become T off. This is simple. So now what happens? You are going to take an LCM here. So because that is in the form of 1 minus 1 by x will be there. Like this form will be there. So after taking LCM, so this 2 comes here. So 2 R naught minus R naught divided by 2. That becomes R naught by 2 only. Right? So simple LCM here. After taking the LCM, now we are going to obtain the like this divided by T off. So now I am going to take it as initial concentration of the reactant in the numerator. So this denominator in the 2, that comes to below this one. Both are same, right? So that is also in the denominator. So right, this is also a denominator, this is also a denominator. So that's why this comes as a T off. Therefore, rate constant is equal to initial concentration of the reactant divided by 2 into half-life period. So now what do I require? We require this half-life period, right? So I am going to be converting. Therefore, T off is equal to, that should be as it is, initial concentration of the reactant. This 2 as it is will be there. Only T off will come this side and K will come to the below side. So this is an important expression for a half-life period of a reaction containing the zeroth order reaction. So here, so this half-life of a period is directly proportional to the initial concentration of the reactant, whereas inversely proportional to the rate constant of the zero order reaction. So this is a simple expression. It tells that the relationship between the half-life period and rate constant of a zeroth order reaction. Let's discuss about the second one, that is called expression for the half-life of a period along with the first order reaction. This is also we can correlate with the one term, that is called the relationship between the half-life period of a reaction and the rate constant of the first order reaction. Both are same. So you know this one, rate constant of a first order reaction, that is equal to K is equal to, just recall this one, 2.303 divided by T log initial concentration of the reactant divided by concentration of the reactant. So this is called rate constant for the first order reaction. So this is equation number 1 I am going to call here. So according to our half-life period, so it tells that T is equal to T of, whereas the concentration of the reactant is equal to initial concentration of the reactant by 2, because our definition, the concentration of the reactant can be reduced to half of the initial concentration of the reactant. So same way, I am going to substitute these values in the equation number 1. Let's see what happens. K is equal to 2.303 divided by, where in the place of T, I am going to substitute T of, therefore log will be there. So in the place of R naught, there is no change here, I am going to write as it is. So in the place of R, I am going to write it as the initial concentration of the reactant divided by 2. Just rearranging these terms, what happens? K is equal to 2.303 divided by T of log. So here, in this after the simple calculation, this 2 comes to the numerator side, and here our initial concentration of the reactant from the numerator and from the denominator gets cancelled with each other. So now I am going to write directly as a log 2 value. Therefore, K is equal to 2.303 divided by T of, so what is the value of log 2? When you look at the log book, so it comes to value as 0.3010 or 0.3020 something will come. So after the simple calculation, we will require this T of, so I am going to sending this rate constant to this side, denominator. Therefore, T of is equal to 2.303 divided by K into 0.3010. So therefore T of is equal to, simple calculation when you multiply this one, we are going to obtain the 0.693 divided by K. So this is an important expression for the half-life period of a half-life period, and this equation does tell the relationship between the half-life period of a reaction along with the rate constant of the first order reaction. This is equation number 2. So what happens here? This half-life period of a reaction is inversely proportional to the rate constant of the first order reaction. But can you find anywhere here? So in the zero direction, we call that half-life period is directly proportional to the initial concentration of the reactant, right? But here there is no initial concentration term here. So that's why in the first order reaction, half-life period of a time that should be independent of the initial concentration of the reactant. So this is an expression for the, so that is half-life of a first order reaction. For nth order of a half-life period, so that is equal to T of is inversely proportional to the, so the initial concentration of the reactant power n minus 1. So this is an nth order for this one, as it for nth order. So let's take, when I am going to take for 0 order first order, what will happen? So now I am going to take it as n. N is the number of values, then it is equal to order, and next column, that is a relationship between the half-life of a period and the initial concentration of the reactant with respect to these orders. What will happen? Let's see here. So I am going to make it a 3 columns here. When n is equal to 0, n is equal to 0, that comes as the 0th order reaction. We know this one directly, 0th order reaction, T of E is directly proportional to the initial concentration of the reactant. Why? Because when you substitute value here, 0, n is equal to 0 means, so R0 power minus 1. So R0 power minus 1 means, so that goes to the numerator, that becomes R0, right? So that's why you got the value like this. For first order reaction, I am going to substitute value n is equal to 1. So that is called first order reaction. What happens here in the first order reaction? N is equal to 1. N is equal to 1 means 1 minus 1, that becomes 0, right? So therefore, T of is inversely proportional to the initial concentration of the reactant power 0. You can write it as power 0, or it is R power 0 is R0 power 0 means it is value is 1. So that's why we didn't get in the first order reaction any initial concentration of the term in this equation, when you look at this equation number 2. So let's go for the second order. So in the second order reaction, I am going to substitute the value of 2 here. 2 minus 1 means 1. So therefore, in the half-life period of a second order reaction, that will be initial concentration of the reactant should be there. That is power 1 will be there, right? So in the first order, zero order reaction, that is directly proportional to the initial concentration of reactant. Whereas in first order, there is no find any this initial concentration term, right? So that's why that is what independent of the initial concentration of the reactant, because power will be 0 here. But whereas in second order, that should be inversely proportional to the initial concentration of the reactant. Let's discuss about the some of the problems based on the half-life period. So that the question has given, a first order reaction is found to have the rate constant 5.5 into 10 power minus 14 per second. Find the half-life period. So it has given the first order reaction. So you know that first order reaction. So before going to that, we should write the given data. What has given? Has given the rate constant. So rate constant is K is equal to 5.5 into 10 power minus 14 per second. So we should find out the T of. So you know the formula for the relationship between half-life period of reaction and rate constant for the first order reaction. Therefore, half-life period is equal to 0.693 divided by K. So this is the formula here. So now I am going to substitute here, that is 0.693 divided by K. What is the value of K here? So we got the 5.5 into 10 power minus 14. So it's a simple calculation once again. So we should calculate the 0.693 divided by 5.5. So you are going to get the DN value 0.126 something around. So this denominator 10 power minus 14, that comes to the numerator, right? 10 power 14 per second, because per second is an unit of this half-life period. So let's go for a simple calculation once again. The time required to decompose the thiolene chloride SO2Cl2 to half of its initial amount is 60 minutes. If the decomposition is first order, then calculate the rate constant. Once again, it is based on the first order reaction only. So it has given the half-life time has given. That is given, T of has given the 60 minute has given. So our aim is to find out the rate constant. What do we mean by rate constant? We need to calculate here. Once again, use the same formula here. So T of is equal to 0.693 divided by K, but we should rearrange here because they require the we should find out the rate constant, right? Therefore, K is equal to 0.693 divided by P of. I have substituted the value here. K is equal to 0.693 divided by T of. What has given? 60 minute has given. So once again, the simple calculation. So when you calculate here, 0.693 divided by 60, you are going to get the value around 0.115. So what is given here? So then you should keep it as time has given per minute, right? You should keep it as per minute only. So because per minute, you should keep it in this one, in this way, right?